Hello everyone. Today I'm going to continue sharing the solution to the recently concluded Pure Math 1 A level variant 3 9709/13/ May June 2025. And I have requests for question 5. So question 5 is related to solving trigonometric equation. So let's go ahead and go through the question. Solve the equation for sine theta tangent theta equals 1 plus 5 cosine theta for theta between negative 180 degrees to 180 degrees. This is a 6-mark question. All right, so as I usually tell my students, right, whenever you are going to solve a trig equation, your aim is to apply either identities or algebraic manipulation in order to get to the end game. What is the end game I usually tell my students? It's a single trig equation, right? A single trig function on one side of the equal sign and then a number on the other side. That's the aim, okay? The aim is to get single trig equal sign a number. That's what I usually tell my students. So right now, our trig equation has multiple trig functions on one side and another trig function on the other side. So it's not the ideal trig function to solve. So we have to apply some identities and algebraic manipulation in order to get to the point where we can then solve this trig equation. So one of the things that we can do is we look at this trig equation and we can see that on one side we have a cosine and on the other side we have a sine. The ideal trig equation would have only a single type of trig function. We have sine, tangent and cosine. So one of the first things we can do is, what if we use a trig identity, the ratio identity of tangent theta. Okay, so tangent theta is sine theta over cosine theta. So we can then replace or substitute tangent theta with this expression. And then we will end up with 4 sine squared theta over cosine theta equals 1 plus 5 cosine theta. The right-hand side still remains the same. Now, the next thing we can do is we can get rid of this fraction by multiplying both sides with cosine theta. And when we do that, we get 4 sine squared theta equals 1 times cosine theta is cosine theta. And 5 cosine theta times cosine theta is 5 cosine squared theta. Now notice that we now don't have any tangent, right? We only have sine and cosine, and we only have we don't have any fractions. Now the other thing that we can realize is we have a cosine that is power 1 here, right? And here a squared cosine. Now if you remember the Pythagorean theorems, the Pythagorean identities for trigonometric equations, right, trigonometric functions, any sine squared theta can be expressed in terms of cosine squared theta, and any cosine squared theta can be expressed in terms of sine squared theta. But single cosine and single sine, we cannot express it as the other one in terms of the other, right, without changing the input or the domain here. So in order, we want to keep theta here. We don't want to have like 90 degrees minus theta. So the only option we have is to convert this sine squared theta and rewrite it in terms of cosine squared theta. So we will use this identity. This is part of the Pythagorean identity, sine squared theta equals 1 minus cosine squared theta. Substitute it in there and we'll get this. Now we have an equation that is only in terms of cosine, theta. So we can simplify. And we will get this form, right? Just bring everything to one side and we'll get this form. So this is what we call a disguised quadratic. That means we can use the method of solving quadratic equations in order to solve for cosine theta and then solve for theta. So this one, if I'm not mistaken, is a quadratic that can be solved using a quadratic formula. So if we apply the quadratic formula, I hope you still remember, right? Negative b plus minus square of b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a, right? So if you apply the quadratic formula, you will get this value, right? Negative 1 plus minus square root of 145 divided by 18. So this is the value of cosine theta. Now, notice that we are going from negative 180 degrees to 180 degrees. And cosine theta is actually symmetrical within this domain. So whatever positive answer that you get from the calculator, if you use your calculator, right, whatever positive result you get, also include the negative result, okay? Because cosine inverse function, right, the cosine inverse function in your calculator will give you any answer between 0 until 180, okay? The cosine inverse function in your calculator will only give you results between 0 degrees until 180 degrees. So, because of the symmetry of cosine theta, right, between negative 180 to 180, always include the negative version of whatever the calculator spits up, okay? So, now, we'll start with one of the solutions here, okay? Let's take the plus, okay? Take the plus here. So, cosine theta, when we want to find theta, we do inverse cosine, right? We do inverse cosine on the solution. So, let's take the one with the plus sign first. So, inverse cosine of this, right? And if you perform this inverse cosine, you'll get 52.16 degrees, okay? 52.16 degrees. This is the calculator answer. Now, because like I said before, due to this domain, right, that means you have to consider the negative angles as well. And due to the symmetry of the cosine function between negative 180 to 180, the other solution is just the negative angle of the solution given by your calculator. So 52.16 degrees. And negative 52.16 degrees. Okay, so that's from using the plus. Then we repeat it. Now we use the minus. Okay, this one, your calculator will actually say 136.43 degrees. Okay, because when the input to your cosine inverse is negative, right, between negative 1 and 1, but if it's negative, between negative 1 and 0, your calculator will always give you a second quadrant answer. So this is 136.43 degrees from the calculator. And again, due to the symmetry of cosine function between negative 180 degrees to 180 degrees, we also must include the negative angle. So we will have four solutions here. So at this point, usually it's already good enough, right? You can stop and you'll get full marks, right, from listing all of that. But usually I'll tell my students, right, it's best to just list all of them at the end, right, so that it helps the grader to see your final answer all together, and they can see if you have all the solutions and did not miss any solution. So you are supposed to have four solutions, and when you list them all like this, right, the grader can see that you have listed all of them. So if you give the grader an easier time, then there's a high chance that they'll be nice to you. They'll be a little bit more lenient to you in terms of giving you the marks, okay? So give the grader a good time, a better time marking your paper. So if you have multiple answers from multiple evaluations, try to list all the answers at the end, okay? So that will be easier for the grader to notice. Okay, so final answer, theta is 52.16 degrees. Negative 52.16 degrees, 136.43 degrees, negative 136.4 degrees, if you have listed all of the solutions, okay, then you will have done a good job.